PCR. PCR is one of the tools used in molecular biology as well as biotechnology. So PCR, polymerase chain reaction. The basic principle of PCR is DNA amplification. DNA amplification. So DNA amplification means multiplication of DNA. So generally the DNA multiplication done by DNA replication in vivo condition. So DNA doubling is happened there. But in vitro condition, how the DNA amplification is going on? Here one special apparatus is used, that is thermocycler unit. PCR is nothing but a thermocycler unit. Here the principle is DNA amplification. It is developed by the scientist Gary Mullis in 1983. He won the Nobel Prize in 1993 due to his achievement. So Gary Mullis, in 1983, he developed the PCR. PCR means polymerase chain reaction. In vivo conditions, on DNA template, the DNA replication is going on. So there is a need of polymerase enzyme and also DNTPs, one template. Okay. So in the presence inside of the cell, there is a need of some enzyme, also helicase enzyme. So, like many components are involved in DNA replication in vivo condition. But here, the double stranded DNA. For example, in previous class we studied the rDNA. Okay, the prepared rDNA multiplication done in PCR. Okay, so the prepared rDNA is, for example, that is this. Okay, so the prepared rDNA and the double stranded DNA, how the multiplication is going on, means for the multiplication there is a need to separate as two single strand. It means unwinding procedure. General in DNA replication, the unwinding is going on by helicase activity, but here the helicase enzyme do not function. PCR polymerase chain reaction. So for DNA amplification, the instrument, the thermocycler unit, so the PCR is used. PCR is developed by the scientist Gary Mullis in 1983. He won the Nobel Prize invention. So the PCR basically to DNA amplification, used to DNA amplification. The small segment of DNA multiplied within second more billions of copies. Okay, so that when you see in cellular level or in vivo conditions, there is a replication is going on. The DNA is doubled there in the presence of many enzymes. So polymerases enzymes, helicase enzyme, ligase enzymes, nucleases enzymes. So the many enzymes collectively work for replication. But here only one enzyme is work for the DNA replication, that is tag DNA polymerase. The tag DNA polymerase is isolated from the bacterium Thermus aquaticus. So the importance of the Thermus aquaticus is it is a thermophile bacterium. It lives, it survives in high temperature also. So it have the enzyme, that is DNA, tag DNA polymerase, that has been isolated from Thermus aquaticus, that used in PCR. Because this thermocyclic unit under control of high temperature. Okay, so this is the DNA segment. So the segment is going to multiply within seconds millions of copies. How it is going on? You see here, this is the segment that is double stranded DNA. Before going to the amplification, there is a need to separation of dsDNA into ssDNA. It means unwinding of DNA, separation of two single strand. Okay, so in vivo conditions, for the separation or unwinding of DNA, there is, that is mediated by the enzyme helicase. But here the helicase enzyme is not used. Okay, here high temperature, application of high temperature leads to the first step of the PCR, that is denaturation. Denaturation. Denaturation means here the bonds between two strands are going to dissolve in the presence of high temperature. So the temperature approximately 95 degrees of temperature. Then they get separated. You see here two strands are get separated. Here few components are used for PCR. What are the components? The first component is DNA template. DNA template. So the DNA template is available in dsDNA. So that is also separated as two single strands, okay, by application of temperature. And next, primer is used. What is primer? Primer is RNA segment, oligonucleotide segment. So this primer is artificially prepared primers. They are commercially available in the market. We purchase the primers, universal primers, and used into the PCR. So the primer is nothing but of artificially synthesized oligonucleotide. Oligonucleotide. What is the function of primer? The primer can initiate the DNA replication. Okay, you see here, the first step of the PCR is denaturation. And the next step of the PCR is annealing. So what anneal here? That is primer anneal to the two opposite template strands. Okay, then next, after annealing, there is going on process. What is that? DNA amplification is going on. For that, there is a need of one enzyme, that is DNA polymerase enzyme. DNA polymerase enzyme. So the DNA polymerase enzyme is, this is the special type of DNA polymerase, that is tagged DNA polymerase. So tagged DNA polymerase means it is isolated from Thermus aquaticus bacterium. Thermus aquaticus. Why we use tagged DNA polymerase in PCR? So PCR conducted in high temperature conditions, hence there is a need of heat resistant enzyme. Okay, so Thermus aquaticus bacterium, it is thermophilus bacteria, it survives above 90 degrees of temperature also. That's why tagged DNA polymerase is isolated from Thermus aquaticus, that is used in PCR. Okay, that is for DNA polymerization. Along with that, DNTP is also required. What are DNTPs? Deoxynucleotide triphosphates. What are they? DATPs, DTTPs, DGTPs, DCTPs. So these are DNTPs required for PCR. Okay, so here you remember one thing, the DNA amplification done within one single test tube, that is Eppendorf tube. So the Eppendorf tube is available, so that is suitable to the PCR machine. So there the DNA amplification is going on. So you see already DNA naturation. After DNA naturation, annealed with the primer. If the primer annealed means the DNA replication is continuous, the replication is going on at the application of DNA polymerase and DNTPs. According to complementation, they are joined to, they are formed at the template strand. It means the newly strand is extended. Okay, so the extension is taken up to 72 degrees of temperature. So then within seconds, many number of DNAs are produced. It means starter DNAs are produced. The number of DNAs produced within the second are, we said, as 2N. 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 NA is nothing but of number of cycles. Number of cycles. If the number of cycles are 30, how many fragments are produced? Here is a question. So, 2 to the power of 10. 2 to the power of 10 means 10 cycles are conducted. 10 cycles are conducted means how many fragments are produced here according to principle 2 to the power of n. So, 2 into 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, that is equivalent to number of fragments produced within the number of cycles. Okay, but what is the importance of PCR? PCR, very limited DNA template also multiplies and gives more number of and million number of copies within the seconds. Okay, that is the main purpose, main function of PCR.